Hello and welcome to another quick look. This time I'm taking a look at this War of Mine, which is basically a survival simulator in a war-torn country. You play as a group of people who are stuck in a city torn by war and just try to do whatever you need to do to survive. It's also often called Depression Simulator because this game makes you feel like shit and question your choices in life, because you sometimes have to do things or see things in this game about human life that are not so good. But anyways, let's jump into the game and see how the game is. Let's go for another try and lose my progress there, but it's fine. It's a lot about trying again and again and learning by failure in this game, so it's fine losing your progress. So day one. So the game is done in this nice black and white style. It's all grey colors and in this nice 2D style side view into the life of these people. So this is the hideout you start in. It's not very good, as you can see. It's full of holes and not really in a livable condition, and you need to actually work and make it much better. And we start out with these three people. The people you start with is kind of random. It's usually pretty much the same people, but there is some variance. Like, there is this female character that I started last time, and I haven't actually seen this guy yet before, so he's Marco, Skill Scavenger. That's quite nice. So this is our hideout, like I said, and you control your guys by clicking either from here or clicking on the guy there, and you can interact with these things. So for example, we should probably start with scavenging our own home and try to see what materials we have here. So here's our things, currently nothing, and we found some raw food, some materials, so components, clean water, wood, electrical parts, and you need to kinda scavenge, find, and get these materials to survive on the long run. Food and water, of course, being very necessary for life. And all these other materials are used to craft things, make beds, and upgrade your house, and just make your life better, and eventually get guns as well to defend you, because someone might actually come and try to rob your house, because you're not the only survivor in the city. Also, you may have to go and try to steal some stuff from other people yourself, and maybe take some lives as well. Let's grab those. Actually, let's grab all of them. Exit. So you go pick up that. Let's see what else we have here. We should open doors there. Some of these doors may actually be locked, so we may not be able to get those. You go there. That is actually locked. In here we have some medicine. What's, yeah, herbs. And some more water and stuff. Get that. Let's go, you go there. Actually, you should open the door here. So this is the first thing you should do. Get the resources from your own home. That's locked as well. He's clearing out that rubble out of there. You go check that then. And you go check down there. You also need to clear out some space to get space for your new things you build. So there's more herbs, some parts, some water, some electrical parts as well. Grab those. And you go check this drawer here. You can open the locked doors with lockpicks, which you can find. Some more stuff for me. Let's see. Some more. There is a lockpick, actually. Grab those. So we can actually open a door now. Let's use you to break out that door. Let's see if that's locked. And you have a clock running here that kind of points that you have to do things quickly, or you will lose precious time, which could be used to scavenge, build things, whatever. So you kind of need to be on the ball constantly. What does it say? Okay, that's open. Okay. Clear out that. You clear out that. Clearing out things where it takes quite a long time. We might want to lockpick this one and get that. Actually, there is nothing up here that we really can get. yeah, let's just clear out things here first. I need a bit more building materials to build some necessary stuff, like a cooking stove, beds, and all kinds of stuff. So you're actually done up here. Clear out that. Grab those. Let's go actually see what improvements we can do at the moment. I might want to save the lockpick if I'm going to go scavenging other houses. We might have to lock some picks there. So we could do improved workshop. Not going to waste materials on that yet. So we need a simple workshop, some components, some wood and some parts. We don't have enough of these at the moment. Let's see about these things. Ah, sorry. That thing. So these are what you can build in a simple workshop. There's a bed, there's chairs, simple heater. It's gonna get cold eventually. You might need a heater, radio, and then crude stove, moonshine still. Booze is always good to have in this situation, makes life happier. Metal workshop, rainwater collector, and then some consumables. You can make some fuel, you can make some filters for the rainwater collector and those. Let's make a bed. And you would drag these wherever you want to place them. I kinda like them in the cellar here, so I'm gonna place a bed there. And he's gonna go and build me a bed. Because, well, you need to sleep somewhere, and having at least a crude bed is better than sleeping on the dirty floor in here. I think Marco, we are actually slightly wounded, will be my scavenger, because he's skilled on that, so he's probably gonna go in the night, go steal some stuff. Actually, I might send Pavle and Marco together. Keep clearing out, that's nice. I might actually lockpick this, just to see what's in here. I hope it's worth the effort. There's some books. Ooh, nice. That's good for morale. Or you can just burn them if necessary. And there's some medication. That's all nice. So the bed is done. Let's see what else can we do. Cooking stove would be nice, and rainwater collector would be nice as well. So we won't waste so much food when we cook. Yeah, we should have enough for a cooking stove, so I'm gonna drag that up here. This is the kitchen area, there's the fridge, so let's place the cooking stove there. And let's see if I have enough for rainwater collector as well. Would be actually nice to get all of those going immediately. Here's my medicine cabinet. I don't have enough. I'm missing one piece of components. Damn. Oh well, I guess not then. We could do a radio though. Let's make a radio. Where do we put the radio? Let's put the radio here, next to the chair. It's a chill out room. Actually, that's not a chill out room, but anyways, the chair is actually there. We'll build some chairs in here. Nighttime should be coming soon, which means we'll have to stop building stuff and just go scavenge. And some people need to defend as well. So there's my cooking stove. We can actually improve that as well with some parts for improved stove. That might be something actually we should do soon. It's not too difficult to do. I just have to find some components, some wooden parts to get all of those going. So I'm actually kind of out of materials now, so I'm probably gonna wait for the nighttime and we'll see what happens. Let's try the radio. Rebel leader instructed us to warn the listeners not to cross this front line. Failure to comply will could result in death. And you can tune in to different things here. I don't really know exactly how the radio works. I'm sure you can get some information from that. And you might find a certain wavelength where you need to tune in later on. Let's see. So we cleared out that. Let's see what's in here. It's locked, of course. What else? Let's see what we can still build. We still have a bit of time. It's only 7:30 p.m. It is quite late already, but I could make a filter. I could make another bed. I guess we could actually make another bed down here, so that when Pavle and Marco are back, they can actually go to sleep. You can also check the bios for all of these characters. They have information here. You can gain. You start out with 3 people. You can gain more people on the playthrough. You can find and recruit some people to your cause, other survivors, and you will lose people on the playthrough as well. Some people may go insane. Some people may just decide they don't want to be part of your group anymore. They may die. All kinds of stuff. So it is quite likely you will lose some people. Oh well. So that's the daytime done. So here's the night, and you have several options you can do during the night. You can scavenge, which is a really good option. At least have someone scavenge in the night. You can guard your house if someone is trying to come and kill you. You can sleep, or you can just sleep in bed. I'm gonna leave Bruno, my chef, in there. He's gonna guard our home. Actually, sorry, guard, not sleep. And I'm gonna send Marco and Pavle. Actually, you can only send one guy. So Marco is gonna go scavenge. And actually, let's do it this way. You sleep in bed, you guard Pavle, and Marco goes scavenging. And this is the map here. So here's our shelter, and there are some locations on the map you can go to scavenge. You see some information about these places. Like, this one has lots of food, huge amounts of materials, lots of meds, huge amount of weapons, and huge amount of parts. Sounds pretty good. Here's food, materials, meds, lots of weapons, parts. Huge amount of meds, parts, and food. I think we're gonna go to Ruined Villa. There might be someone living there. It doesn't say any danger or anything at the moment, so not too bad. They say some people still live here against all the odds. They must have some supplies stocked, like canned food, possible bandages, and medicine. They don't want to trade. If you are desperate, we could try to steal from them. Maybe not go there then. If there's... yeah, there's actually better locations. Let's go to the abandoned cottage. So there is a locations in the map where there will be other people living there. You can trade with them, you can, well, steal from them, you can kill them even. Killing may not be the best idea, because your guys are not battle-hardened soldiers or anything. They are actually just civilians, and, well, fighting for them is not something that comes naturally. They're actually pretty bad at fighting. And also, it's gonna affect their morale if they just have to murder someone cold-blooded just to survive, so that's also not a good option. So yeah, let's scavenge the abandoned cottage. Pavle keeps guard during the night, and Bruno takes a nap, so he can work during the day, and Pavle and Marco can take a sleep during the day time then. So let's prepare for that. So this is the scavenging part. So Marco has 15 space on him. He can take some supplies with him if he wants to go. So if you are going to go on a trade run instead of scavenging, you may want to pack some tradables on you. Also, if you are if you have lockpicks and weapons, you might want to grab those along if you happen to need those on the run. But I don't think there's anyone living in this house, and we don't really have any of those lockpicks or weapons to use. So I'm just gonna leave a lot of space so we can scavenge as much as possible. So let's go scavenging. And scavenging is kind of same like your own house, but happens in some other location and works exactly the same. You can interact with things here, you can have stuff in there. Ooh, gunpowder, parts, and components. We need components at least. I'm gonna try to get some lumber as well. Someone is actually there. That might be not a person, though. That's a lot of stuff. Let's take a look. It's not a person, I think. Something must be blocking from the other side. Let's go down here, then. I think it's a rat. This should have been abandoned. A lot of wood. Let's grab all of that. I'm gonna pile these in a single location when he's full of stuff, but for now I'm just grabbing everything. If I need to suddenly run, at least I have a full inventory. Let's put that there. And let's take one more lumber. Have one more space. So I'm gonna leave those in there. That's pretty good. But I'm kinda hoping to find something other than building materials as well. Here we go. Weapon parts. Those we're gonna take. I'm gonna drop lumber, take books. What else is here? Rolled up cigarettes, fertilizer, and coffee. Coffee could be actually nice. And fertilizer, when we get farming going, fertilizer is gonna be nice. These are gonna stay here, actually. So, it's kinda prioritizing what you want now, and you can come back later on and grab those as well. Kinda want to take the parts as well. Roll up cigarettes, Yeah, let's take cigarettes. Cigarettes are gonna be nice. I might come here next night as well, just to get the stuff we have here. Some more building materials to build all the water collectors and stuff. Stick that. Those can stay. Or we can just leave this here, and whenever we happen to need stuff, we can come here. Family photo of parents and two daughters. Good thing the girls don't resemble their father. He looks like a bear. Nice. There should be food in here. It is. I'm gonna leave that. There's also sugar in there. That clean water is actually quite nice. Tin water. So we don't actually have to build the... don't have to build a water collector as that soon. Food is gonna be quite vital. There is a ton of sugar for moonshine. I think we're gonna make a moonshine distillery next night. And let's pick up this in here. Shell casings, oof. Yeah, I'm definitely coming here the next day as well. Maybe not clear at that. It's gonna take a while. And that's only a door there. Let's see what else we can find first. Note says, on the first day, they robbed us. 2 days later, they murdered our girls. I shot every one of them, but I don't want to use the gun anymore. It's broken and buried in the backyard. The next part looks shaky. If you're reading this, don't look for me. So the gun is buried in the backyard, so I should probably take a shovel and come here and pick up the gun. Because, well, there's a lot of stuff here. Anyways, it's locked. There's probably something in there. Don't see anything yet. Well, it's still not too late, so I'm gonna clear out a bit of this. At least do some work on it. If only I can have some kind of shovel. We should probably try to get the shovel, actually. And just leave this here for now. Yeah, I'm gonna leave that there. And I'll try to get a shovel, come back here, collect all the other materials we need from here. Clear out that and check out the cabinet door there with the shovel. And clear out the door so we can easily access. I think we can actually maybe pick up the gun, which would be actually nice. So reading and looking through things. Yep, there it is. Broken pistol. Well, I guess we are taking the pistol. Because we might be able to fix it with the gun parts. Yeah, this looks like a pretty good haul for the day. We got some food, we got a lot of water, we got some building materials, gun parts, broken gun, some books, and some gunpowder as well. We need to pick up the shell casings there to make some ammunition. Coffee, cigarettes. Pretty good haul for the night. Let's just leave now. And Marco is back. Let's see what's the damage from the night. Let's see if someone robbed us or something. Day 2. Good haul, nice. Night was calm. Marco has been searching for supplies and brought some interesting things. Nice. So Marco is now hungry, slightly wounded and tired. You can go back to sleep. Bruno, you fix that. Let's go cook meal for Paula. Actually, let's do it differently. You're the chef. Go cook. And Pavle, you'll finish the bed, and you can also take a nap. So Marco goes to sleep, because he was doing good work. So we need a fuel. Let's use the lumber as a fuel for now. And we'll make cooked food. How many? Oh, we only have. Well, you should actually make two more firewood and make three meals for all of the people. Because you're actually a cook, so that's good, nice. He's a smoker. Can I actually see the skill set? I guess that's the skill set there. So the bed is done, you can sleep as well. And you go. Making some meals for peoples. And there we go. Food done. You eat one of them. Good job, Bruno. And while the other guys are sleeping, you can go check out. Was this locked? Indeed it was. Let's see what we can do. We still can't make the rainwater collector. I need to go get those components. Really badly. So we cannot really build anything today. So getting a lot of components should be my goal for the next day, and lumber. When we go into the other house. Oh, yeah. Definitely need to get that. I should also make the metal workshop. I'm missing one for that. So I cannot really get the shovel or anything yet. I don't think there's anything we can loot from the house here. Let's open that door, actually. Yeah, it seems. I really should have picked one more component. So you actually should do some planning before you leave. What you exactly need. Oh well. Okay, the door is open now, so you go. Still slightly sick, recovering. Slightly wounded, recovering. Tired. Well, we cannot really do anything at the moment here, so we're just gonna have to wait till the end of the day. Or actually, while they are sleeping and waking up. I think we are gonna. Okay, he's now hungry. Go eat. Are you still sleepy? You're still tired. Well, you can still sleep. How are you? You're fine. I'm gonna use the medicine to heal him, his sickness. Hopefully he'll be better. So a lot of wood and components to make the rainwater collector tomorrow and improve my metalworking and everything. Good. So you are now slightly wounded. I don't have anything to heal you with, so you can sit down for a moment. And Bruno, just hang around, I guess. All of these things were locked, so we couldn't really open anything. Can you actually get there? Was this locked as well? Shame we don't have like a crowbar or something, just break through the doors. Maybe in the future we can do that. No, it's locked. So you are now good. Go eat. So we are gonna do the same next night. We are gonna leave Pavle on guard. Bruno will be sleeping, and Marco will be scavenging. I might actually gonna go to a different location, just to scout out, because parts and wood are really common in all locations. Well, most locations. So it should be fine. Let's get some medicine for you. So you're now only slightly sick, and you're on the meds. You can go actually to bed, why not? Go rest. It's gonna recover you a bit if you're in the bed. So you go sit on your chair there. Yeah, on the meds and recovering, that's really good. And we can actually just go and end the day now. Because we don't have anything to really do. And go for the night. So we get the supermarket now in there. There's a huge amount of parts, huge amount of weapons, lots of food and meds, but there's also danger. In there. We are not gonna go there. There's shelled school, food, materials, meds and parts. How's this looking now? Some meds, some weapons. materials and parts and ruined villa. Let's go check out the villa, actually. There might be someone living there, but it's fine. So you scavenge, you sleep, and you guard. The same as last night. Let's see what's in here. And I'm not gonna take anything with me again. The shovel would have been nice. But we'll make the shovel tomorrow, and we'll go from there. It's raining. We need those badly. Let's actually look through the door before we go in there. My legs went numb. Someone is actually living in here. Just one more minute. So I'm actually stealing from someone else. I wonder who lives in here. Whoever lives here has a lot of parts for me. I think that's about enough. Let's take one more stack. Let's look through there. Let's try to be sneaky. Nothing in there. Can we open this one? Could try from other side. I'm gonna see if these guys are friendly or not. It's a lady. Let's open the door and go to talk to them. They don't still see me, by the way. Let's sneak and see what's in here. Private property. Well, they don't know I'm here yet. You can also hide in here if they come for looking. It's a woman's diary. She writes a lot about a man called Emil, apparently. He owns his house and she made friends with him while treating his wounds. After she moved in, he began to reconcile with his wife's death. At least these two found some consolation in this mess. We may have to just run it. Oops. That's fertilizer, some more parts, gun parts, and electrical parts. The lady's down here, so maybe I'll sneak a bit more here. More fertilizers and parts and electrical stuff. I think we should maybe just leg it now. We know they live here. Well, they still don't see or hear me, so might as well check a bit more. Yeah, definitely. Roll up cigarettes take a lot of space. I thought they would probably stack. Oh, that's quality roll up. Nice. I'm not sure what to drop. Let's drop the one stack of these. I want to get the tobacco. It's gonna make the chef's life nice. He gets something to smoke. I think she might hear me now. Ooh, bandages and herbal meds as well. I'm not gonna take those. Let's go check the upstairs quickly. More fertilizer, gun bars. We are full on those. Yeah, I think this has been a successful steal. He's actually sleeping. Or on the bed. Uh-oh, she's moving. Run. What's that noise? Go. You didn't hear anything. That was a successful steal. Whew. Successful sneaking. Quite nice. Let's see what we got. Let's hope there was not a raid or anything during the night. Night was cold. Nice. And we got good loot. So, Anyways, this is basically this world of mine, and this is how you play the game, and you try to survive in this water-torn hell, and see how you go. It's not gonna go well, I can tell you that. At least not your first few hours of trying the game. Things go bad in this city. But anyways, I highly recommend checking this game out. It's been a blast to play the game. Also, it's been a rage all over the internet. A lot of people seem to like the game a lot. But it does make you depressed and question your choices in life when you have to murder an innocent old elderly couple just to get some medicine and food to survive you yourself. But anyways, thanks for watching again. I'll see you guys next time. Have a nice time.